Hi, my name is Manuel Likani. I am Dean and Professor at CTOR Academy, and I'd like to welcome you to another session of CTOR Channel. The topic for today's discussion is OneCouple System. The simplest system in orthodontics is when we have only one attachment, one bracket, on one tooth, and in the other side, we have only button. What's the difference? If you have an attachment, you touching the wire in 2 points. We call it two contact points. On the other hand, if you have only one button, you connecting to the wire through only one contact point. If you have two contact points, you can make a couple. If you have one contact point, you are not able to make a couple. Let's see what happens if I'm putting a section of wire from one side to a bracket that can make a two contact point with the wire, and from one side to a button that can only make one contact point with the wire. Let's take a section of piece of a straight wire and from one side bring it up to the button of the canine and tie it to the canine. What forces and moments appears in my system? As you remember from previous discussion when we were talking about the equilibrium, I said the easiest way to analyze your system is through the wire, because the teeth are not in equilibrium with each other, but the wire receives forces and moments from the two adjacent teeth, and therefore when the wire is in equilibrium, easily we can see the forces and moments in the system. So if I bring the wire from one side up to tie it to the button, I apply the upward force on the wire. Why the wire doesn't move? It means the total forces on the wire is zero. Can you guess where is the other force comes from? Yes, from the other side of the wire when it's attached to a bracket. The bracket applies a downward force on the wire. So from the total force in the system is zero. However, something strange happens here. If you look at the blue arrows, there are two forces equal with each other, opposite in direction, but with a distance from each other. They define the meaning of the couple. And if they are like a couple, they should cause a rotation. And the rotation in this wire would be counterclockwise. But the wire doesn't rotate now. The moment that you're putting the wire inside your patient's mouth and you tie it to the bracket and the button, the wire stays in equilibrium, which means there should be another couple in the system. Can you guess where is the other couple? Yes, the only place that have a two contact point that can produce a couple is the purple arrows that applies on the corner of the bracket that produce a clockwise moment that cancel the counterclockwise moment produced by blue arrow. Now the wire is in equilibrium. But how we know what applies on the tooth? A simple way to see the amount of the forces and moments on the tooth is just by reversing the direction of the moment and forces applied on the wire. On the canine, we apply the upward force to the wire based on the third law of the Newton. The wire applies the opposite force, same in magnitude, on the canine. Therefore, you have an extrusion force on the canine. And the bracket applies a downward force on the wire in the premolar side, and therefore the wire applies an equal and opposite reaction to the premolar, that is upward force on the premolar. And similarly, the couple applies a clockwise moments on the wire, and therefore the wire applies a counterclockwise moment on the tooth. So as you can see, the canine and premolar receive forces that are opposite in direction with what the wire receives. Remember, canine and premolars are not in equilibrium. The wire is in equilibrium. Canine and premolar, at this moment, they are in equilibrium with their periodontium or surrounding tissue, which goes through the remodeling, and after the remodeling, therefore the tooth will move. Something here is require your attention. Do you remember how we measure the magnitude of the moment that is produced by a couple? Yes, by multiplying the force times the distance between the two forces. So if I say how much is the magnitude of moment produced by blue arrow, you say if the distance between them is d1, therefore the magnitude of the moment produced by blue arrow would be f1 times d1. How would be the magnitude of the moment produced by the purple arrow? Similar to the previous discussion, it should be f2 times d2, and here the d2 is the width of the bracket. And because the wire is in equilibrium, one expects that f1 times d1 to be equal f2 times d2. This is very important clinically. So it means that your one couple system is very affected with the width of the bracket. As the width of the bracket decreases, one expects that the magnitude of the moment that appears in the system decreases. With that means the magnitude of the forces in the system decreases. This is under assumption that you don't change anything in your system. Now, assume we are decreasing the width of the bracket narrower and narrower and narrower until we reach to the size of a button. Now, the bracket only contacting the wire as one contact point. What happened to our system? As you can imagine, the magnitude of the couple reached to the zero. In another word, it cannot produce a moment. How that gonna affect the one couple system? Well, there will be no one couple system. Means that there will be no force and there will be no moment in your system. Now you understand why they call it one couple system. You may assume, wait a minute, there is two couple in the system. Why they call it one couple system? It's very clear. Only one of your tooth receive a couple. The premolar, the canine, has only one contact point and did not receive a couple. Therefore, even though we have a two couple appears in our system, based on definition, only one tooth receive a couple, and that's the premolar in this example. When we are analyzing one couple system, so far we were talking about the forces and moments that the wire produce on the teeth. But how the teeth reacted to these forces? It's another story. Nothing to do with the one couple system. So one couple system doesn't know what teeth, what shape, what length, what inclination is in both sides. It applies just equal forces opposite in direction, and one side also receive a couple. But how do those teeth react to these forces? That requires separate analysis. So for example, in the sagittal view, if the force passed through the center of resistance, the reaction would be just movement, extrusion or intrusion. How about if we're looking at the frontal view, or a cut through the long axis of the tooth where we can see the buccal surface and lingual surface of the tooth. So for example, in the premolar that receive an intrusion force, the force does not pass through the center of resistance of the tooth. Depends on the inclination of the teeth. Therefore, the distance between the force and center of resistance can be different, and therefore the magnitude of the moment that appear in this dimension would be different. This is not produced by one couple system. This is the reaction of your tooth to one couple system. Therefore, you cannot say these moments should be equilibrium with the other side of the wire. No, they are completely independent. How about the canine? The canine receive extrusion force depend on the inclination of the tooth. The moment that appear in the system can be different. Again, these two moments are not in equilibrium. They are not equal to each other. And depends on the inclination can be different. I hope you enjoyed the topic of one couple system that we started today. This topic is a large topic that we need several sessions to devote to understand the full aspect of it. Next session, I'm just going to study the effects of different factors that can change one couple system. And then through that understanding, session after that, we talk about how we can set a one couple system. Thank you again for watching another session of CTOR channel. Please don't forget to subscribe if you so far did not subscribe, and don't forget to like us. Thank you for your support.